Hi everybody. Okay, day two of sourdough starter making. Now yesterday, just a quick recap, I took 4 1/4 ounces of 3 different flours. I did a wheat berry, hard red spring wheat berry, freshly ground through the mill. We did a rye flour and then King Arthur bread flour. And we mixed it with 4 ounces of pineapple juice. Organic would have been nice. Now today, day two, we're going to take this mix and combine each with 2 1/4 ounces of each flour and 2 ounces of pineapple juice. Now, one thing that you have to notice is that yesterday we drew lines to see if it was going to rise or not. And it didn't, but that's okay. It's just getting started. When I pulled the lids off of these, and even now, you can smell the pineapple juice and you can smell the various wheat berries. Like, the rye has a little more earthy tone. The wheat is wonderful. And the bread actually doesn't have that much scent to it at all. But having said that, what I'm gonna do the bread first. We'll tear the mix to zero. Now I'm going to add the 2 ounces of pineapple juice. Now make sure that the pineapple juice you're shaking well. I just shook this earlier, but shake it well because you do want the sediment off the bottom. And if you're more secure pouring into something else before pouring it into the bowl, do that. I don't know, you can always, since it doesn't get mixed in, you can always pour it off if you pour a little too much because it is easy to slip. Then we're going to add 2 1/4 ounces of the bread flour. So that's going to take this to 4 1/4 ounces total. And then what we're going to do is give this a nice even mix. Now, because that was liquid before, I'm using a pretty stiff silicone spatula to mix this in. I could use my hands, but I think this is going to do a fine job. And this is going to become quite a bit more loose than the other batch, just because it has now a bit more liquid, as the flour from the first batch was fully hydrated by leaving it. And I did leave this exactly 24 hours. And so, anyway, that's that. And I want to take this smaller when it fits the bowl a little bit better. And just make sure that it's cut in well. Okay, then what we're going to do is, this is a nice, really soft dough. And it has some life to it. You can see that it's starting to move around now. See how it kind of bounces back? And it has life in it. So this is a good start to the starter. And that's just the unbleached, unbromated, all-purpose bread flour, which the protein content is a bit higher in. So that looks good. Now we're going to put that back in the container. Now I will do the rye flour. Put this in here. This one's a bit stickier. I did the white first because I didn't want it interacting with either the wheat or the rye, since it's such a nondescript, unflavored flour. We'll tear that, and then we'll put our 2 ounces in here and 2 1/4 rye flour. Now, mix this up. This dough is quite a bit stiffer than the white bread flour. So we have this mixed well. It's mashed down in here really well. And I'm sort of drawing the spatula through it to make sure that I do have all the flour mixed in with the pineapple juice. And it looks good. This is going to its appropriate container. gotta pat this down in here since it's a little more pasty than the other one and get a nice even top on it so we know how much it's going to be activated. Okay, now we're going to mill up some fresh wheat berries. Easy, fast. Oh, as a point of reference, the 2¼ ounces of the wheat berries were shy this half cup measure, but you do want to weigh it. It's just more accurate. If you were to weigh this full, it would probably be 3-3½ ounces, which is too much. Anyway, we don't want to screw the starter up in the beginning. Now we want to add 2 ounces of the juice. Now we're going to add in, just make sure I've got the right one, the Bob's Wheat Berry. Now you'll notice on the top of this how it turned a darker color. That's all fine. Smells great. This actually is getting a little life in it too. And you'll see after I get done mixing it, it's not as, because of the gluten content, or the protein content, rye flour doesn't have that. So that turns in more of a paste-like thing. Whenever you're working with rye flour, if you want to turn it into bread, you almost have to work it in with some other kind of wheat berry, whether it be white bread, whole wheat, makes no difference what, or use a darker rye and mix it in with another wheat berry of some sort, because the rye does not have gluten in it, which is the protein content, which gives the bread its elasticity. Anyway, so you can see that this now, it's almost worked in, not quite. Might have to work this one with my hand. Wheat flour, freshly milled, absorbs a bit more water. So it's gonna seem a bit more dry than, you can see the difference, than this, than the white bread flour. And what we're gonna do is just make sure it's hydrated well by mixing it in this bowl. And it's sticky, but you can see that this has life in it too. See how this is starting to move around nicely? So into the container it goes. Same one is just fine. And God, it smells wonderful. That fresh milled wheat is just heavenly. Okay, so now on go the lids and put a new line. Put this on top of the other one so we can see how it has grown from day one to day two. The bread flour, not so much. This is the rye, and this has puffed up quite a bit by the time the second edition came in. And then this whole wheat is up about as much as the rye. So there you have it. I hope you're following along. And I'll see you tomorrow. Tomorrow we're going to put, we're just going to be putting straight water in tomorrow and no more flours. And 3 more days to go and then we're making bread. Okay, thanks for joining me. I hope you share this with your friends because I had someone yet today message me and asked, where am I going to get yeast? So I called around and I found a few stores that have some, but they're rationing from their offices so that no one starts hoarding it because there's just not that much. And after they go through this supply, they have no idea when they'll be getting more. So your friends might want to follow along with this too, because it's sort of a good skill to have for some time until we get some yeast and flour back in the mix. All right, see you tomorrow.